Hello everybody, and welcome back to the show.
I was last night browsing YouTube Analytics. It's a place YouTube has for creators where all the numbers live, statistics. View numbers, audience regions, percentages, ages, different platforms, and pretty much whatever you can imagine. Well, I don't go in there too much, because I like to think of what we are doing here as mostly fun. And if not cautious enough, all those numbers can spoil it. But yesterday I did. And after some time of browsing all the different tabs in there, I decided that this channel is not getting the traffic I'd wanted to have. So I will be making some changes. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the shop here today for a quick special. I'm just messing with you. No changes. And I love watching this guy. Today we are talking post processors. So it is mostly about running Marlin on a mill. A quick video with some things I feel I should have mentioned when making this machine, but I actually forgot to. And here is another run for comparison. Running GRBL on an Arduino Uno. Now there were some folks that decided to move from this setup to this one and be able to enjoy all those nifty features like the LCD display, SD support, live feed rate adjustment, etc, etc. But they hit a bump. Or not. It all depends on the software. Now the way a typical milling operation works is this one. Let's say you want to mill just the square on this surface here. So you have that. Just a square. Now you have to worry about CAD. You have to get to a piece of software to design your wanted square. How big is it gonna be? How wide is gonna be the groove for each side? How deep? What you are gonna use for that is called CAD software, and there is a great variety available. And now that you are done with that, you need a CAM program. This is what takes your design and makes a machining operation out of it. You specify the tool you're gonna use for the job, your maximum feed rate, your plunge rate, which is usually smaller, and mills don't plunge very well. You also specify your spindle speed, maximum depth of cut, your tolerances, etc, etc. And in the end of the day, it calculates your toolpaths. The routes your tool is gonna follow inside your material to give you the desired result. This is a very important part of the procedure, with so many parameters that we could talk for days, but not on this video. Now you need to convert those toolpaths into G-code. It's the machine language and what your controller can read, translate to I/O signals, move things around and get the job done. You need a text file containing something like this to feed on your machine. And to get that out of your calculated toolpaths, you need the post-processor. But don't get terrified on me here. Let me show you right away. Here I am running Fusion 360 from Autodesk.
It's an amazing piece of software for our purposes, very powerful, including both CAD and CAM, and it's free for students, educators and hobbyists. It's something I use very often, and it's also a great place for me to make my point regarding this video you're watching. On the screen you can see the spanner I made out of aluminum on a previous video using the Quartz. So I already have a CAD file and a calculated toolpath inside CAM to manufacture this. This toolpath I'm gonna tweak a bit right away, since we are not milling aluminum here today. And now it's time to post-process. So I go ahead and click on that funky icon up here. And there we have the post-processor window. And let's start by typing a name for this program. Now let me restore the whole thing to the default configuration folder, so we can talk. There. If you are used on using Arduinos to control your mill, then most likely this is the configuration you are gonna use. Generic GRBL. And let's do that for now. And try it on the machine running GRBL.
So I stopped this by unplugging the USB for a good enough reason. I don't have a way yet to control this router's speed, so it's turning at 33,000 RPM. The feed rate it was running here was about 350 mm per minute, which is way too slow for a 4-fluted 6 mm end mill, making less than a millimeter deep cuts on a particle board. So I was burning a perfectly good end mill
and was ensuring a place in hell for my soul.
But you get my point. It is working. Now let's try the Arduino Mega and Marlin. As you saw there, the machine is not reading the piece of code I just put into that memory card.
And that's because Marlin is configured to read files with a G-code extension. Files containing G-code in general come in various formats. They can be .nc files, like the one you can see here and stands for numerical control. Also .tap files are pretty common and I believe there are more. Marlin reads just the .gcode ones. And I'm sure you can fix that somehow inside the configuration. But there's also a similar way. All those files will be in straight ASCII code, I believe. Same as saving a text in Notepad. So you can just go there and rename the file to the extension of your liking. Pardon me here, no capitals. Now,
we should be able to see that. There. And let's give it a run. Okay, wanna see that one more time? So Z-axis is going forever and ever. It is going to hit the physical boundaries, and I have to hit the red button. Apparently something is wrong. And let me show you what's wrong.
This piece of code we have post-processed for a GRBL controller, and for that it is working like a charm. But this time we are trying to execute it on a machine running Marlin firmware. And for that we are gonna need the according post-configuration. This situation here, trying to post-process for Marlin inside Fusion, guys on GitHub have already taken care of. You just go there and download the post-processor extract it inside a folder on a known location, you select that folder inside Fusion as your configuration folder here, and the CPS file you will find in there as your post configuration. Again, type a name for the thing and post again. Now check this out.
Okay, I was also using the burnt end mill, which I ended up burning even more. But you get my point one more time. It's working. Now for the sake of argument, I will put a two-fluted one and finally mill the cycle. There, you saw how fast you can destroy a perfectly good endmill, especially if you are an idiot and use a 4-fluted one when you also have a same diameter 2-fluted. You also saw the difference between a good and a spent endmill. Have a look at them cuts. That's quite a difference, isn't it? So that's what a post-processor is all about, and as you saw, it's not terrifying at all. In fact, machines that use features like auto-tool change use their own post-processors regardless their control software. Now for other pieces of G-code producing software, there is no need for such a fuss. A code made on Iazel per se, or F-engraved, will work on both the machines as is, as long as you put a .gcode extension on the end of the file to recognize it inside Marlin. But I went with the worst case scenario here, and the solution is quite simple. So that's all for today, folks. Thanks for being here, and see you next time. Have a nice one.